The Parliamentary Committee of Rules, Privileges and Discipline today reconvened after 2 months to proceed with the inquiry into the case of misconduct against the Mitiana Municipality legislator Francis Zake, which was committed in November 2022. The committee vice chairperson, Father Charles Onen, delivered a ruling in the application made by Zake's lawyers to have the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, appear for cross-examination. Onen ruled that Tayewa's appearance was not necessary. He says all evidence that was captured in the video and on Hansard of Parliament is sufficient enough for the committee to conclude the matter.
In November, the committee is corroborated by the video evidence adduced before the committee, which shows honourable members making submissions for the conduct of Honourable Zake on the material day. They are therefore relevant in aiding the committee understand the basis upon which they made their submissions during the plenary and their observations regarding the conduct of Honourable Zake at the material time. For that reason, the request to invite them as witnesses is granted. Honourable Derek Nyeko, Honourable Frank Kabuye, and Honourable Gilbert Olanya, it was the evidence of the wing of Mr. Wing John Bosco, the doorkeeper and the sergeant at arms office, that the three honourable members, to which Honourable Nyeko Derek, Honourable Frank Kabuye, and Honourable Gilbert Olanya, were engaged in misconduct together with Honourable Zake on the 29th of November 2023.
The chairperson's revelation shocked Zake's lawyer Elias Lukwago and his client Francis Zake, who had attended the committee proceedings. Lukwago noted that if the complainant is not allowed to appear before the committee, then there is no case to answer.
If that were to be the case, we would know. Because defamation has also to be particularized. It's against a particular individual that you did this, which disparages so and so's name. And actually, they are ingredients of that particular charge of defamation. We would expect, if that were to be the charge, for those issues to come out clearly, that this is what you did, which is considered to be denigrating the person or integrity of the speaker. But it's not coming out. So what is it that they are choosing Zake of? It's not clear. This is the thing we are complaining about. What is the offense they are choosing him with?
Francis Zake, the accused, claimed that the leadership of parliament is waging a witch hunt against him.
They expect me to defend myself. So let's watch the space, but this is a waste of time that I shouldn't even be able to give time.
The chief opposition whip, John Baptist Nambeshe, appeared as a last witness today and defended Zake's actions. Nambeshe further added that he was shocked when he had the deputy speaker direct Francis Zake to the Committee of Rules, yet they had settled the matter in his chambers.
It looked unusual to discontinue the member from submitting or raising the matter. And that's why you saw me comply with the speaker's direction. When he said, Rob, talk to your member, I was pleading to him to relax and cool down so that sanity would prevail and the presiding officer would allow him to conclude on the matter.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.